Hi everyone, I'm here with Yuna, who's a founder of Locket, and I'll also be speaking to her co-founder, Kaushik, later in the course. Yuna, can you tell me a little bit about Locket and sort of how you got started?
Sure, so it's a company that's 2 years old. I used to work in an investment bank, and that was my first job out of college. And the idea was, this lock screen that we're staring at 150 times per day, it's nothing better than just a photo in a clock currently. Mm-hmm. Can we do something better than that, was the idea. So then I quit my job promptly, and then I started building the team. So that's where I found my co-founder, Kaushik. And then we moved into a two-bedroom apartment where I lived with five other guys and three dogs, and then living out of the bedrooms and then working out of the living room. So that's how we started. And the V1 model was to, hey, can we show ads on the lock screen and get paid from advertisers and pay users to just rent out their lock screen. So that was our initial start. Mm-hmm. Started off as like a very ramen noodle startup, like kind of like a project, and then it just like suddenly became a company after we started fundraising and such.
Great. And how was like the early user adoption? How did you guys start finding users and getting that traction?
It was very abrupt. We thought that we would get like 10,000 users in the first month, and that's how we calculated all these other ad sales and all that stuff. We ended up getting 25,000 users on the first day, and then we ended up getting a million users from that V1 model, which ended up failing. So which is why we pivoted into a different model, which is showing content on the lock screen. Oh. That app is launched. It's called Locket, and it's launched in the Google Play Store, mm-hmm. and it will show relevant news on your lock screen. So that, and every time you wake up your phone, it'll show different news, so that you're keeping the know.
Great. Yeah. And so you originally had the product, which was ads-based, and then you moved mm-hmm. into news because you thought that was bigger traction. It was something that was in demand and people wanted.
So the way in which our thought process worked was we couldn't pay. So when we were doing the paper ad swipe model, mm-hmm. What happened was because we got so many users in a short period of time, it was impossible for us to plan out the next ad cycle, mm-hmm. because we without knowing how many millions of users we'll have the next month, it was impossible to sell the ads in advance. Mm. And also not only that, because advertisers pay us 3 months months after the ad campaigns have been finished, so we were in business of paying users first before getting paid from advertisers.
Yeah.
So we needed to raise a lot of millions of dollars. And we're just a 3 months old company.
Yeah.
So we had to make a decision, we're not going to do this anymore. Then what is the other type of value that we can provide on the lock screen? Mm-hmm. And the idea was, we just tried out the economics model, which is paying and rewarding users. Can we deliver the right content at the right time and delight users that way? And then, when we were pivoting, we showed we were just testing out by showing some of these other articles, Justin Bieber just went to jail, or did you know that this airplane had X, Y, and Z? And the engagement on those articles were really great. So then we went to talk to these media companies who wanted to partner us in order to distribute the content.
Huh.
So that's kind of the transition in which we kind of made. And also user base changed a little bit too, because when we were paying users, it was the users that really valued that $3 to $5 per month. Mm-hmm. Whereas as we are moving towards the content model, it's the users that are hungry to learn more and just get these content.
Oh, interesting.